Looky here, who we have now. We have the band who've just been on the pyramid stage. We have Adam, we have Edge, we have Bonham, we have Larry. So was it was it as good? Oh, sit down.
You only just started drinking the black label. What's going on?
So yeah, we have offerings here for you if you need a touch of whiskey or anything like that. Was it as good as Edge sold it to you last year? That's what I want to know, because I'm sure it was kind of him coming back.
I was very, 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 very taken aback by the warmth of the crowd to us. And, you know, we have not played to anything other than our own audience for 25 years.
Get out of here.
So we've not played, which is kind of already weird.
Live Aid.
So you don't, no, we played.
That was the last time.
Was that live?
No. I mean more than two songs. We never played.
Right, a proper set. Okay.
When was the last festival? Yeah. You must have worked it. Someone must have tried to work it out.
1985.
Wow.
What must have been a real stinker.
I was there, I think. God.
The Eurythmics.
I was indeed there. So describe what it's like for you, this whole experience, this whole Glastonbury experience.
Quite overpowering. And, well, I walked out and I didn't know this was like an ice rink. So I couldn't move because it was rain all over the city. So I actually couldn't move and reverse that myself. It likes to move about. It was interesting. So I just thought, just stand where you are and just sing. And maybe the singing will be better for me not being able to move.
We had a roof, which was amazing, because if it rains in our production, we just get wet. Yeah. So we were under the roof, and it felt wrong, so I had to go out from the
serious
way. So I was there with everyone out.
What did it look like? From your
view? I am a man of the people.
From your bird's eye view, what did it look like?
I love the fact that they, you know, the flag thing, that they did the flags just for us.
Primal Scream had no flags. They had one flag, that's all they had. You had all the flags.
We felt very, very... honoured that they would do the flags just for us.
They were very nice.
No, they were great. I love the
flags.
Did they
get the tricolour and the Union Jack on?
Yes.
Yeah, you got that. No, you were fine. Don't worry.
That was beautiful.
We can debrief after. We have plenty of time to debrief afterwards. Okay. I just want to say, as far as, you know, we can gather here, everyone was gathered around the TVs, and we're in a situation where we could watch it, like the millions of people watching it all around the UK and inevitably the world. And, you know, it was beautifully directed. Looked wonderful. Sounded great.
The songs were beautifully sung. The guitars were beautifully played. The drums were...
It was nicely...
The drums were probably the best thing.
Lots of wonderful wide shots.
Too slick. You know, you don't want to get too slick. That's not true.
I wouldn't mind a bit of slickness.
Well, we were definitely not slick.
A lot of slickness on the vanity stage. A lot of slickness.
We were a bit all over the shop, but in a good way.
Most slick of the day.
You know I'm going to point to Larry. Come on, every time. I mean, we've got to talk about the set list, because so much talk about the set list in the lead up to this, and it doesn't often get talked about as much, but then it's been 30 years or so, you know, since Michael Evers said he's been trying to get you to do this festival. I think he's rounding it up a few, but still.
He's an extraordinary man. They're an extraordinary family, really.
Well, look what they put on for people every single year. I mean, it's incredible.
But it's also
and for the
what
village.
They do, the philosophy behind it, their generosity, not just of spirit, but their actual generosity. They're amazing.
Well, there's a lot to play for, you know, outside of the people just on the field. You know, there's the legacy and there's the heritage of this festival, and the songs are what we're going to carry you through tonight. I mean, you know, there wasn't the claw, there wasn't the things that you put into the production, so it's about the tunes.
Five songs from Acting Baby. To open.
I know, brave. And that's why I said it was very brave. I didn't call Even Better to start. I was trying and I didn't. Did you get the set list, by the way?
Yes.
Yeah. Obviously, you never got, so I guess it didn't.
Well,
okay.
Yeah,
I thought it was very promising. Very promising.
But still, choosing the tunes, top one.
I hope the Damon Hirst piece went out, because he really sweated over the details of
tell
that.
Tell us about that. Tell us more about that.
This is, you know, greatest living artist. And he did a piece of work for Even Better Than the Real Thing, and so no one has seen that ever before. It was a real moment.
This was the opening when you
the opening. All those visuals during Even Better Than the Real Thing were courtesy of Hirsty, and you know, to have his genius behind us was a great thing, and it kicked it off. And then we went into The Fly.
Yeah, I know.
So I said Dead Flies, courtesy of Hirsty.
Oh my God, can you hear the rain thundering down on us at the moment? This is insane!
No.
This is Glastonbury, this is what it's like, you know?
We just had gentle rain.
Well, it was... It was pouring with rain when I was introducing you, can I tell you now?
What an introduction, though, honestly. Well, actually, you didn't hear
it,
but
you,
she
Larry,
went,
so much.
You too, and you just went, boom, it was like you guys were in sync. It was remarkable.
Best intro ever.
I mean, I was just thinking about this, you know, with the with the rain tonight and that what that adds to the sense of occasion, and it really took me back to, you know, Under a Blood Red Sky, and that gig changed your lives, didn't it?
Red rocks.
Yeah.
But without the rocks.
Yeah.
Well, you know, the atmosphere.
Or the red.
Or the red.
But and you didn't climb on top of the stage this time either,
was mist and all
couldn't
that.
I would have. I couldn't.
There are a few more people there tonight than there were at Red Rocks.
It's been great having you here. I'm really glad that you ultimately finally decided to come and do Glastonbury. Do you enjoy it?
Yes.
Yes?
So much.
And you know, you know that song, Jerusalem, for an Irish boy to sing that, you've got to admit. But you know, there's a story about Glastonbury. People don't know that that song that is sung, Jerusalem and England, is all this mythology about Joseph of Arimathea coming to Glastonbury. And the oldest abbey, Christian abbey, in Northern Europe is here. Everyone talks about Stonehenge and all that, man, which I'm cool with, but it was a real pilgrimage for me. I actually got onto that tip. And then I used some of the lyrics in Bad also. Did you? Unless,
I got that.
Were you comfortable with that?
One thing, Larry, how was it for you?
I enjoyed it.
I was a little disappointed.
But.
No, it's not a but. It's just, I was a little disappointed that it was so wet. I mean, a little bit of rain's okay. It just seemed to be, for the crowd, they were kind of stuck together. But one criticism, if it's a criticism, the audience is so far away. And sometimes when you're struggling through it, you just love to have them just a little bit closer. There's a huge gap. And I'm not used to that.
Shouldn't have been a drummer. Should have been a front
man.
Always had the looks. Unfortunately, blessed with rhythm. Not much you can do about that. Ladies and gentlemen, you too. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you so much.